For the first time during this pandemic, the Delta variant has created a new challenge for hospitals.
While hospitalizations are going down, the need for ventilators is going up. THV11's Ashley Godwin tells us how our largest healthcare systems in the state are managing a virus that is worse than ever before.
COVID's a little different now than it was in the early days of the pandemic.
This makes people sicker faster, and it definitely is affecting more young people.
Once it comes in, and if a patient becomes into the ICU, those patients are in the ICU for a little while.
COVID hospitalizations in Arkansas have gone down over the past 2 weeks, though some of the numbers are unclear due to backlogs in reporting. Something that is clear, though, our record high ventilator usage.
But the percentage of those patients that are sicker and requiring ventilators has risen significantly. It's really more than doubled in the past 3 weeks.
The Delta variant seems to cause more severe cases than the older COVID-19 variants. UAMS noticed the difference immediately.
We were down to about maybe 8 to 10 ventilators in-house. Saw that very early on because the surge came in very quickly.
When a patient gets sick enough to need a ventilator, they often stay in the hospital for weeks.
What further complicates it now is how many young people we have on the ventilator. And so they can actually survive on the vent for a long time, but decline over weeks instead of days.
When someone gets sick enough to need a vent, the survival rate is discouraging.
About half of the people who go on a ventilator do not survive. So it's just a very worrisome thing to have so many people with COVID-19 on the ventilator in Arkansas.
So hospitals have continued to add more bed space and ventilators, hoping to fulfill the need.
So we've just added 12 new ICU beds, and they're almost immediately full. It's just really remarkable how we keep adding beds and we keep getting patients to fill those beds.
In Little Rock, Ashley Godwin, THV 11 News.
Baptist Health told us 95% of the patients using ventilators right now were not fully vaccinated. One more number for you to keep an eye on tonight, active cases. You will notice that they have dropped just a little since early August, but the drop is barely noticeable. It's clear that they are much higher now than they ever were in the spring. Also, 86% of active cases are unvaccinated.